My name is Vanessa Hall, and I am 50 and fly. I was born March 9th, 1964, to two wonderful parents, Bertha Morris and James Morris, and I am a Grady baby. I grew up in Herndon Home in Atlanta, Georgia, and we moved to Ben Hill, where I furthered my education at Thurrell High School. I was Miss FBLA, Miss Sweetheart, Miss Ninth Grade, and I was a majorette, a flag girl. So many different things that I did at my high school. I played basketball, softball, I ran track, several medals in track, I jumped hurdles. I can truly say I am every woman and every girl. And I had a wonderful upbringing. And also, later on in life, the Lord allowed me to have a wonderful son, Anthony, who was the heart of my life. And not only him, but I ended up marrying a wonderful man by the name of Bishop Stephen B. Hall, who I love very dearly. And out of that, he had a son and I had a son. So we are a great blended family. We really know how to make it work. And then we adopted a wonderful daughter, Ember, and she is married to Craig. And then I have four grandchildren at 50. Can you believe it? I mean, 50, half of 100. It's hard to believe, but I am there, people. I am so there. Take me to the King. In my life, I had to overcome some obstacles. What most people don't know about me, and I often say this in my testimony, that I've dated hustlers more than 30 years ago. And I've had some of the finer things in life at the age of 18, driving some of the best cars, living in some of the best neighborhoods. Wasn't really just proud of that, but the Lord allowed me to overcome those things to get me where I am today. Because if I had never experienced those things with the young men that I dated, I couldn't help you young ladies out and to give you life experiences. And sometimes experiences is the best teacher. And not that mama or dad or grandmom didn't tell me that I to not do those things, but I was kind of hard-headed and I wanted to find out for myself. And because of that, I'm able to minister to a greater level because of my past experience. And the Lord assured me one thing in all of that, that He would never do any more for me than when I was in the world than I am right now. And I can assure you that I have superseded that and more with the love I get from my husband, the love I get from my family and my church, that you can overcome those obstacles coming out of the ghetto or living in the ghetto to having the finer things in life. And without, I can truly say, all of that wouldn't mean a thing if I didn't have God in my life. And it's because of Him that I live, I breathe, and I have my being. And I learned that at an early age. I was brought up in the church. That's all I knew. But I strayed away. And the Bible talks about train a child in the way it should go. And when he gets older, he will not depart. And so I was trained by the best, by good parents, that I strayed, but I came back. And the Lord gave me grace and mercy to do that. So I am godly grateful for the obstacles that I've overcome. It's wonderful to be 50. When most people fight 50, I'm so overwhelmed and so happy about being half of 100. I never really thought about it at first, but now that I'm thinking about it, it's great. I may not just feel like I'm in the best of shape, but I think I look all right to be 50. Brian, you say I look great. I am embracing 50. I've had friends that did not make it this far. And the ones who have made it in my class, they don't look like I do, and not even doing half the things that I'm doing. One is just serving God, who makes it all possible, and I could never do anything without Him, and I must say I owe it all to Him. And not only just Him, but my mother and father had great genes. They look good, and my grandmother. So I think I aged very well at 50, and I'm looking so forward to just getting old gracefully.